Welcome to Final BSc Statistics students. In this lesson, we discuss efficiency between systematic random sampling and simple random and stratified random sampling. Between systematic sampling and stratified random sampling. We have discussed the variances in both the sampling techniques. In the comparison of stratified random sampling with the systematic sampling, how the stratified random sampling is being compared with the systematic sampling in the point of view of the systematic sampling, and what are the formulas for the purpose of comparison. We have all discussed clearly the points. So now we consider, we have calculated the variances. Variance of y bar st and also variance of y bar sys. Variance of y bar sys, that is with the formula of rho wst and s square wst. Now I recollect the formulas, I write the formulas, and then we can calculate the efficiencies. So now I recollect the formulas first. What is the formula of the variance of y bar st? Variance of y bar st. The formula here, k minus 1 by nk into s square wst. It is the formula in comparison with systematic sampling. This s square wst is nothing but mean square within the systematic, within the stratum. In the comparison of systematic sampling, s square wst is the population mean square of the population between the units within the stratum, that is s square wst. So it is a comparison. Now if you compare with the variance of y bar sys, I write variance of y bar sys systematic sampling. Now it is the formula of k minus 1 by nk into s square wst multiplied by 1 plus n minus 1 into rho wst. So these are the two formulas we calculated for the purpose of comparison, that is to comparative analysis, to make the comparison between systematic and stratified random samplings. These are the two formulas we derived and we calculated for the purpose of comparison, comparative studies. We did the calculation, we have separately calculated. So now you see, now we can compare because of the formulas have been converted. Formulas have been converted in terms of s square wst and rho wst, k minus 1, nk, k and nk. So that, therefore, now we can able to compare. Now we are able to compare these two particular formulas. How the efficiency is going to be calculated? Efficiency of VT2, it is going to be calculated by variance of T1 by variance of T2. So that is the formula of efficiency. Efficiency of a particular estimator is going to be calculated by, for example, if we want to calculate T2, variance of T2, it is going to be calculated, efficiency of T2, it is going to be calculated by efficiency of T2, it is going to be calculated by variance of T1 divided by variance of T2. That is the actual formula of efficiency. If efficiency is greater than 1, then T2 is the most efficient estimator. Efficiency is less than 1, T1 is the most efficient estimator. That's what the usual calculation of efficiency, the comparison of efficiency. Efficiency is calculated with the help of the variances. Simply we can say which particular variance, which particular estimator has minimum variance. Then such estimator is known as efficient estimator. That is in usual sense we compare in that fashion by the definition of efficiency. So therefore now what we calculate? I calculate efficiency of systematic sampling. SYS. Efficiency of systematic sampling. It is going to be calculated by variance of Y bar ST divided by variance of Y bar SYS. Is it right? As per the formula is concerned, the efficiency of systematic sampling is going to be calculated by, in comparison with stratified random sampling, variance of Y bar ST divided by variance of Y bar SYS. So this is nothing but this. Here we have the two particular formulas, we divide it. So it is equivalent to B. You divide this. Right? So variance of Y bar ST is this, variance of Y bar SYS is this. Now we can cancel out this entire term, K minus 1 by NK squared WST here as well. So therefore, the efficiency of systematic sampling is equivalent to V. SYS is nothing but 1 by 1 plus N minus 1 into rho WST. This is the formula of the efficiency of systematic sampling. Now we have to see further which is more efficient. In the stratified random sampling or systematic sampling? Either systematic sampling or stratified random sampling, which is more efficient? For which, if you know the nature of rho WST, remaining of constants, L is constant. Only if you learn and know what is the nature of rho WST, it depends on the value. The efficiency. Efficiency depends on rho WST. If you observe the nature of rho WST, the correlation coefficient within the stratum, that is between the units of the within the stratum, if you observe it, then we can give the some kind of conclusions to efficiency of systematic sampling. So now I take some of the values of systematic sampling, that is rho WST, and so that efficiency of systematic sampling is being compared with the stratified random sampling. So the efficiency is there on the board, 1 by 1 plus n minus 1 into rho WST. How the values are going to be considered? If rho WST is equivalent to be 0, the correlation coefficient within the stratum, it is 0, then this becomes 0, 1 plus 0 is 1, divided by 1 by 1, it is 1. So therefore, efficiency, in this case, efficiency of systematic sampling is 1, which means both systematic sampling and stratified random sampling are equally efficient. They are equal. Both the sampling techniques, if rho is equal to 0, rho WST is equal to 0, then efficiency is equal to 1. Then in such a case, that is if rho is WST is equal to 0, then both systematic sampling and stratified random sampling are equally efficient. And for example, if rho is greater than zero, if it is greater than zero, and this n minus 1, it is always a positive value. Why? Because n should not be considered as 1. To have a meaningful sample size, n should not be 1. N should not be taken as 1, more than 1. So obviously it is a positive value. If you consider n is equal to 1, it becomes 0. N minus 1 becomes 0. So we should consider n more than 1. So therefore it is then efficiency which is less than 1, efficiency of systematic sampling which is less than 1. Oh, why? Because why I am taking this particular value? Because n is equal to 50, 50 minus 1, 49 multiplied by some particular value. Rho it is rising bit, that is greater than 0. The maximum value of correlation coefficient is 1, that is it rising between 0 and 1. As far greater than 0 is concerned. So it takes the values between 0 and 1. A particular fractional value, let it be 1 by 2, 0.5. 1 by 2 multiplied by some 49. It has some particular value plus adding some another particular value. And 1 divided by some 25, which is obviously less than 1. So that is the reason why I have calculated in such a fashion that you consider a particular value so that efficiency of systematic sampling is less than 1 whenever it is greater than 0. Rho WST is greater than 0. If rho WST is greater than 0, then efficiency of systematic sampling is less than 1. If efficiency is less than 1, systematic sampling is not efficient than the stratified random sampling. If E is less than 1, then stratified random sampling is more efficient than the systematic sampling as far as the variance are concerned. The variance is lesser. Variance is less for the stratified random sampling. Variance is minimum for the stratified random sampling as compared to the systematic sampling. Therefore, efficiency of systematic sampling is more. Stratified random sampling is more since it has a minimum variance. The variance of the stratified random sampling, it is minimum. It is lesser than the variance of this systematic sampling. So therefore, efficiency of stratified random sampling is more in this case than the systematic sampling. If you get the efficiency of systematic sampling is less than 1, E, the value is less than 1, then stratified random sampling is more efficient than the systematic sampling. So we have observed, these are the two particular meaningful observations we have, so that I have taken this particular, these two particular cases. So one rho is equal to 0, rho WS is 0, then efficiency is equal to 1, both are equally efficient, stratified and systematic. And if rho WST is greater than 0, then efficiency of systematic sampling is less than 1. Therefore, stratified random sampling is more efficient than the systematic sampling. So these are the two conclusions we made. That is in general, stratified random sampling is more efficient than the systematic sampling. Thank you.